Dear friends, in this video, we will familiarize ourselves with .NET Framework with a Visual Basic perspective. First, what is a .NET Framework? .NET Framework is a software development framework for building and running applications on Windows. .NET Framework is a part of .NET Platform, which is a collection of technologies for building apps for Linux, macOS, Windows, iOS, Android, and so on. What is this .NET platform? Let us try to have a look on. .NET is a developer platform made up of tools, programming languages, and libraries for building many different types of applications. There are different types of applications that we are going to build or that we can build, and hence there should be something common, right? That something common is offered with .NET standard, which is a formal specification of APIs that are common across .NET implementations. This allows same code and libraries to run on different implementations. So what are these three implementations? So with the different implementations, our applications can run on different devices. So .NET applications or apps can run on many operating systems and many machines using different implementations of .NET. .NET Framework, which is quite popular and which we need to study a little bit more, is used to run .NET applications on Windows platform, Windows operating systems. Each implementation allows .NET code to execute in different places or environments such as Linux, Windows, or mobile operating systems. .NET Framework is for Windows, and it allows applications to run in Windows operating system. Whereas .NET Core is a open source, which is hosted on GitHub, that allows cross-platform compatibility. This supports Windows, Linux, and Mac Macintosh operating systems. Xamarin or Mono enables apps to run on mobile devices such as iOS and Android. So all these apps can be written in the .NET supported programming language such as C Sharp or Visual Basic .NET. Now we are revisiting what is .NET Framework. .NET Framework is used to create and run software applications on Windows. What kind of applications we are going to create? Here we told about creating, right? Which kind of applications? That can be websites or services or desktop applications. It is not just limited to all these things. There are many more. So this .NET framework is the original implementation of .NET. From here, everything got started. Now let's get into the architecture. We write source code in programming languages such as Visual Basic or C Sharp, which is compiled with the help of appropriate compilers. After the compilation, what is generated is not the actual machine code, but it is common intermediate language file or assembly. So this assembly will be containing instructions in common intermediate language. They are not actual machine codes. So this intermediate file will be converted into machine code whenever required. So this common intermediate language file has the future. This file can be run on common language runtime provided by .NET framework. So common language runtime or CLR. This is an environment which supports everything for the application which is written in common intermediate language or which adheres to .NET standards. So in which programming languages or which languages we can write the code to be able to run in common language runtime? The language can be anything that should adhere to common language specification or common language infrastructure specification. So this is quite important. This defines inter-language compatibility. This defines a standard set of standards, such as different types supported. The types which are enabled in a common language specification are supported by common language runtime too. So the programs written in different programming languages, which is confront, which are adhering common language specification, can talk to each other. They can communicate with each other. They can be used with each other. The library which is developed with C sharp can be connected to visualbasic.net or vice versa. Likewise, all these things are possible only because they are having something common. The data format, their libraries or the procedures which are behind the scenes, all those things are common. They are common because of this common language runtime and common language specification. These common intermediate language files, which are generated as a result of these things, can be converted into machine code whenever it is required. So why or how they can be converted? They can be converted with the help of just-in-time compiler, JIT compiler. So this is quite similar as of the Java programming language. This looks familiar, or this looks similar, but there are differences. .NET implements it in a different way, but to a higher level perspective, it looks like similar. So let's have a look into these components to a bit more perspective. Now, .NET applications are written in C sharp, F sharp, or Visual Basic .NET programming languages. This code, source code, is compiled to a language independent format or a common intermediate language format. In your syllabus, it is called as Microsoft Intermediate Language in this format. So they are converted or they are compiled into this format. So compiled code is stored in something called as assemblies. Assemblies are files with .dll or .exe file extensions. Libraries are stored as .dll, whereas the rest of the applications usually .exe. When an application runs, CLR or Common Language Runtime takes the assembly and uses a just-in-time compiler to turn it into machine code that can be executed on the specific architecture of the computer where it is running. So what is this CLR? There are two major components of .NET framework. The one is Common Language Runtime or CLR. The another one is .NET Framework Class Library or Base Class Library. So what is this Common Language Runtime or CLR? So it is the execution engine or it is the environment that handles running of applications. It provides everything which is required for running of applications. The provisions are services like thread management, garbage collection, type safety, exception handling, and there are many more, such as interface or interaction related things. The base class library or class library provides set of APIs, application program interfaces, and types, data types for common functionality. So everything which is common is written here in the class library. So it is common for different programming languages to the most extent. It provides data types or types such as strings, states, numbers, collections, so on. The class library includes APIs for reading and writing files, connecting to database, drawing, user interface, the controls, so on. So this is why, because the .NET framework is so rich with all these things. The class library or the common language runtime, this got so popular because it makes application development on Windows platform or now cross-platform very easy. So that is why this .NET framework is so popular and it is used by many developers. Being said all these things, I wish you very happy time with .NET framework. Happy learning. See you.